Dear students, I will explain how to draw epicycloid here. So here I have underlined, it is rolling on outside, so automatically it will be the epicycloid. Two diameters they will give, okay. One is generating circle, another one is the directing circle. So generating circle radius is how much is given, 40 mm, and directing circle radius, the directing circle diameter is given 150 mm. Here diameter is given, so please underline that, it's not radius, okay. So if the circle is rolling on the straight line, see here, if the circle is rolling on the straight line, if the circle is rolling on the straight line, the covered for one complete revolution, this circle can cover the distance 2 pi r. This circle can cover the distance 2 pi r. If the circle is rolling on another circle, we are finding theta, that theta is how the distance covered by the circle. This theta is the distance covered by this circle. So only we will draw this sector. We will draw only this sector. We no need to draw this total circle. Only we will draw this sector. So to draw this sector, we have to find the theta. Okay. This theta is nothing but the covered circle, covered distance. Okay. Sir, can we find by 2 pi r? Yeah, you can find by 2 pi r, but it's not the straight line. So it is the curve. So the curve distance you cannot take by the scale. So that we have to take the theta. So that theta how to find? We discussed already that small diameter by big diameter into 360 degrees. So small diameter means generating circle. Capital D means directing circle. No need to remember the terminology. Directly small diameter by big diameter into 360 degrees. You can take directly. Otherwise, if you want to take radius, smaller by capital R into 360 degrees also you can take. Smaller by capital R into 360 degrees also you can take. Now, if you see the problem, so here to find the theta value, so what we have given, given 40 mm is the small diameter, capital D is the 150 mm into 360 degrees. So small diameter by big diameter into 360 degrees. So if you find this value, you will get a 96 degrees, right? So with 96 degrees with 96 degrees, what you have to do first, you have to draw the sector. To draw the sector, generally you can take the sector like this. Okay, you can take the sector like this. So generally we will prefer V-shaped sector. Sir, why we have to draw V-shaped sector means to utilize the space, to utilize the place properly in the drawing sheet, we will draw like a V-shape. Okay, so first of all, to draw V-shape, blindly draw a inclined line, any inclination. You can draw with any inclination, right? So firstly, draw a inclined line. So here with the sector radius is how much? 75. 150 is the directing circle radius. So 75 is the 75 is the directing circle radius. Okay, so for this line take 96 degrees. For this line take 96 degrees exactly, difference 1 degree exactly. We have to draw with the angle. So 96 degrees like that. First of all, draw the V shape with the 75 radius. So 75 radius. So this is what, this is the directing circle sector, the distance covered by the generating circle. So complete the sector first. So this is the sector. If you draw the circle here, the circle covered distance it is. Okay, now we have to draw the circle outside. If it is hypocycloid, we have to draw the circle inside. So draw the circle outside. How to draw the circle outside? First of all, extend this radius to 40. Because sir, why 40? Because the diameter is 40. So like this, we have to extend the radius. So this radius we have to extend. So here I will draw every line as dark, but you don't draw every line as dark. I will tell you which line we have to take dark. Okay, so indicate the 20. This line is 40. So indicate the center point and draw the circle outside. Draw the circle outside. So draw the circle outside, and after that we have to divide it into how many parts? Circle we have to divide it into 8 parts. Circle we have to divide it into 8 parts. So without using protractor, I will divide it into 8 parts. First of all, draw a perpendicular line. Don't use a scale, you will not get exactly. So what you do is, here you use this protractor to 90 to this diameter. Okay, first of draw the perpendicular to the diameter. Draw the perpendicular to the diameter through the center. Yeah, so like this we have to divide it into 4 parts first. After that, to divide it into 8 parts, set the compass to more than radius. Set the compass to more than curve, half of the curve. So this is half. Take more than half of the curve. Draw a curve outside like this. And cut the curve from this end. Okay, so take more than half, draw the curve, and from this cut the curve. And here also, this side also, draw the curve, cut the curve. You can use a protractor also, 45 degrees 45 degrees, no need to worry. You can draw with the 45 degrees 45 degrees. You can divide it into 45 degrees 45 degrees also, no need to worry. So like this, you have to divide it into 8 parts. After that, after dividing 8 parts, we have to divide this sector into 8 parts. To divide it into sector into 8 parts, first you divide this sector into 2 parts. First you divide this sector into 2 parts. So to divide the sector into two parts, from any one end, take more than half. This is half approximately. Take more than half, draw a curve from this end, cut the curve. So after that, through the center, divide it into how many parts? 2 parts. Divide it into 2 parts. Okay, next, again this curve divide it into 2 parts, this curve divide it into 2 parts. Again, take more than half, draw a curve from this, cut the curve. Same this side also, draw the curve, cut the curve, center as reference, 2 parts. Apply to this also, take more than half, apply to this also. So divide it into 8 parts. Simple, only one step I have done here. First sector 8 parts, circle 8 parts. This is the step 1. Okay, when it is started rolling, this point will be the first point, initial point. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, like that we have to give numbering. Also we have to give numbering 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, like that we have to give the numbering. So give numbering like this. Okay, after giving numbering, O as center, see here, O as center, draw the curves from every point. From 8 points we have to draw the curves. From 8 points we have to draw the curves. I will draw one curve. By saying that, you have to draw all remaining curves. First of all, 0 to O to 8. O to 8 already drawn. So now O to 7. If you draw O to 7, this curve will pass through exactly 1. This curve will pass through exactly 1. So this curve will pass through exactly 1. So this is the curve. Okay, this is the first curve. Next, again O to 6, O to 5. Like that, all of you draw all the curves. So like this, you have to draw the curves. How many curves? Count here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 5 curves. Also in cycloid, we have drawn the 5 straight lines. Here one more instruction you have to remember is, we have to draw a separate curve through the center. We have to draw a separate curve through the center. Remember this point. A separate curve through the center. O to center as radius, draw the curve, central curve. So small curve, big curve. This is the small curve, big curve. Like this, if you draw, you can see the difference clearly. So like this, you have to draw the separate curve through the center, and extend this 1, 2, 3, 4 onto the center line. See here, 1, I have extended up to central curve, and 2, central curve. Like that, all of you extend the lines. So extended every line onto the central curve. After extending, all of you indicate the points as C1, C2, C3, C4, like that. So this is the center positions. C1, this is first point is C0, C1, C2, C3, highlight the points, C4, C5, C6, C7, this is last center is C8. Like this, we have to indicate all the centers. After indicating the centers, procedure will be same. First of all, set the compass to the radius of the circle. How much radius of the circle here? 20. Or otherwise, you set the compass to 20. From C1, cut the first curve. From C1, cut the first curve. Indicate this point as P1. Next, from C2, cut the second curve. From C2, cut the